Up jumps an attendant. Not required. Starter said go. And they're off and they're racing. Blazin, Kazar, Zadar, Rock, Rippet sideways. All away together nicely. Going forward, Tiff's Lad, also Allegiance pressing up. Tell Nothing settling closer towards the rail inside of them. Then Beats of War, followed by Play with Desire, greeting the judge. Four Lane is next from My Fair Valentine, Burn Bray. And dropping out last, getting over from its wide gate is For Your Eyes. Zadar Rock was able to work down onto the rail and leads them at the crossing. 1,600 left to travel. Zadar Rock about a length and a half in front from Allegiance, the pace on. A further two next of all is Rippet sideways, running fourth, Blazing Kazar, in what's turning out to be a strung-out affair. They're followed after a length, covering ground, Tiff's Lad, getting around the outside of Tell Nothing, Beats of War, sticking closer towards the rail. A length and a half off those, Play with Desire from Four Lane, and then came My Fair Valentine, Burn Bray, second from last, and whipping them all in is For Your Eyes. Down the back of the course they go, 1,100 to run. Zadar Rock showing the way. Zadar Rock for Duran. Out by over a length, running second. Tiff's Lad has done plenty of work here through the early and middle stages. Down on the inside, Allegiance third. Followed then by Blazing Kazar. It's been a really evenly run race. Good tempo right from the get-go. Rippet sideways is fifth. A little over a length, Tell Nothing. Beats of War back there about midfield from Play with Desire. About to work into it now. Four Lane behind those. Followed after three quarters, My Fair Valentine. They're starting to bunch up now from Burn Bray, who's going to hit a bit of a traffic jam coming into the turn, and For Your Eyes will peel off around them three and four deep as they set sail for home. 400 to go. Zadar Rock was headed by Tiff's Lad. Tell Nothing goes up to join it. Beats of War stalks them all. Allegiance is next, followed after two lengths. Play with Desire continuing to make ground. Tell Nothing, though, had raced to the front inside the 250. Beats of War's in pursuit, and now Play with Desire cutting right back toward the inside of them, finishing full of running. Beats of War, Tell Nothing. Play with Desire is coming. It's Beats of War, though, in front, close to home from Play with Desire. Beats of War will win. Beats of War home in the last of the day. Got there to give Jason Whiting the third leg of a treble. Beat home Play with Desire, Tell Nothing. And then further back, For Your Eyes from the tail had made up ground. In behind them, Burn Bray struck a few traffic problems. Then came next of all, pulling up behind them, Tiff's Lad, Zadar Rock, My Fair Valentine, Rippet sideways, Allegiance, Blazing Kazar, and behind them last home is Four Lane. Great day for the fish. He's got a bag full. Three. Beats of War. Travelled up well in running, coming off 31 days between outings, but had a really economical run from Barrier 1. And the solid tempo certainly brought him right into the race. Play with Desire tried valiantly. Tell Nothing third. For Your Eyes from last was fourth home. Burn Bray, you could see, getting into some bother, coming to the corner and running into a bit of a dead end. Beats of War for impressive racing, along with Madamas McGrath, Walker, Humphreys, McCleary, Hayes, Ritchie, Magro, Roland, Spitchia, Baroni, Graham, Shepherd, Hoff, and Jarvie. Well done to the Gull as well there with the Beats of War. D. McAuliffe prepares, and Jay Whiting, two winners and a dead heat win as well this afternoon. Interim numbers 6-2, 12 and 3. 6-2, 12, 3. A length by 1 and 3 quarters, 2-17, 3-7. Here they ran, and 36-57, the concluding sectional. Runner-up, Play with Desire by Playing God from Desired View, Willie Pike for Dan Ben Pierce, and Tell Nothings by Star Witness from Dynesque, Julie Mitchell and Craig Staples weighing in third place. Okay, let's go down to Lockie to round it all out this afternoon on a day which has ended on a very, very good note for Jason Whiting.
Certainly has. Thank you very much, Darren. Brings up a treble for Jason Whiting, and Darren McAuliffe's team continues to go along really, really nicely. Darren, Beats of War, a month between runs. What were your confidence levels like heading into this 2,200 metre event?
Yeah, well, I had him spot on when he was supposed to run a few weeks ago, but just trod on a little stone and, you know, had a tiny little foot bruise, so it wasn't 110%, but, like, we've kept the work up to him, but I just couldn't have seen him getting beaten today. He was absolutely spot on, and anyone that I've run into between now and then, sort of, they're probably pretty good terms themselves. Yeah,
from Barrier 1, he always looked likely to get a lovely run in behind the speed, and For many, many years, Jason Whiting has had a lovely habit of getting these horses to relax in staying races and then fine for him in the on the concluding stages.
Yeah, well, I mean, Fishy and I have had a wonderful association for many, many years. He was, you know, when I was training in town and in Albany, he was my number one rider. And, you know, distance has sort of strung us apart a little bit. But I've known all along that he would suit this horse and also, again, tomorrow, No Peer. So he's just got beautiful hands and can get horses to switch off that other people can't. So, yeah, terrific ride.
He's a four-year-old, still relatively lightly raced. What do you do with him now? Does he progress to Saturday company over these staying journeys?
Yeah, well, I had him sort of really tuned up for Saturday a few weeks ago, and, yeah, he got that little stone bruise. But, look, yeah, he's a Saturday horse in the making over a bit of ground, so very, very happy with him. And, yeah, we'll go to Saturday.
Team's going well. Well done.
Lovely, thank you.
There's Darren McAuliffe after the win of Beats of War. Scott never really looked like getting beat in the run. Always had plenty of horse underneath him, did Jason Whiting, and when he pressed go, I thought he found the line quite stylishly.
And probably for connections too. I think he broke his maiden on a soft seven lock, so they can have fun with him over winter too if he isn't quite up to that sort of grade that they hope to reach this time in. You can always have a bit of confidence that he'll get through the wet tracks. I actually backed him first up at 1,200 off the back of a good trial, so I know now why I didn't collect, because he needed some ground. Fishy today looked like he got a perfect run there.
Yeah, no, it all worked out beautiful. Tempo was lovely. Could just switch him off early, and sort of when the couple of moves happened about the 700, just give me an opportunity to get off the fence and start to track into it, and the horse had done the rest.
Whipping the left too, showing off now.
I was trying to lay in a little bit behind the horse I was following and trying to get back in behind him, so I thought I'd get over into the left and try and straighten him up.
And three for you today. Now, Little Fish, your number one supporter, it's school holidays. Where is he?
He's at home. I've only got one at Pinjarra tomorrow, so he'll tag along for the ride tomorrow. I try not to bring him too much, even though he'd love to come every meeting. I don't want him driving with the jockeys mad too often.
Congratulations. Well done, mate.
Cheers. Thanks.
There's Jason Whiting. What a day in the saddle. He brings up a treble with Beats of War and Darren McAuliffe to take out the Own the Dream. Registration's now open to handicap. That's all we have time for here at Belmont Park. It's good night from Scott and I, and we look forward to seeing you at Ascot on Saturday afternoon. You give is why you don't deliver, stuck in a